Good day everyone, you are welcome to my tutorial channel. I am Peter Emanje Adaviruku. Today I want to introduce you to a GIS mobile software called SW Map. SW Map is an Android GIS software, very good for data collection. So I want to take you through the interface of this software today. Please remember to subscribe to my channel. Thank you. So let's go to the main screen of our phone now, since it is an Android phone. So the first thing to do is to go to Play Store and download this software. So let's open and go to Play Store. Make sure your internet connectivity is on. Then when you get to Play Store, just look for SW Map. SW Maps, and click on it. So it will load. So this is the icon of SW Map. So click here to install the software. So it's installing. Pending downloading. After downloading, it will install. So let's wait for it. Depending on the strength of your, it's a very small software, very light software. So it will soon finish downloading. It's already installing. So let's install it. So it has been installed. So two ways, either you open directly from here or you go to the main screen and look for the software. So let's go to the main screen and look for it. So this is it. This is it, SW Map. So you just check on your main screen, you will see it. Or you go to the list of your app and you will see it there. So the first thing to do is, number one, before you even open this, make sure your internet connectivity is on. And secondly, make sure that your location is on. Check on your location. Make sure the location is on, because it makes use of the locations. So now that you have done that, then click on the software to launch it. So when you launch the software, of course, being the first time, you allow to use the app. So click on allow. So when you click on allow, this is usually how it's usually look like. I think the software is developed in Nepal, so the default locations it will give you is Nepal. So what to do now is that you click, since you have enabled your locations, so you click on this icon to take you directly to your location where you are. So when you click on this, it will zoom to your locations. So you can see now I am in Kasna Ram office doing this video. So this is my location is here. So now this is how the software looks like. So this icon here, this big icon, is the menu bar. If you click on it, you see a lot of other menus that you can you need to use as time goes on. But this tutorial is just the interface, introduction to the interface. So you can see the interface here. So this, for example, let's use this GNSS status. If you click on it, that GNSS status is the one that tells you your location, your longitude and latitude, all this information, the number of satellites in view, the number of satellites in use, the latitude error, longitude error, everything, informations will be displayed there. So let's click on this to close. So if you go back to that icon again and click, for example, this sky plots, click on this sky plots, it will bring this sky plots for you to see the number of satellites you are connected to, and of course the strength is also displayed. So another thing I want to show you is here under this layer, this icon represent layer. If you click on it, it will display something like this. So from here you can choose your background map. For example, the background map, the default background map is the Google terrain. So you can choose it. If you click here, you choose any of this base map, Google satellite, Google hybrid, Google terrain, OpenStreetMap. So let's choose this Google high satellite, for example. If you choose Google Satellites and you close this, this is how it looks like. This is Google Satellite. But the problem here is that the name labeling is not there. Location's name is not there. So that is, but it's very clear, no shadow. But the locations, the places are not labeled. So if you click back on this layer and change the base map, click here, and change it, for example, Google Hybrid. So if you click on Google Hybrid, then you close. You can see that the locations are showing, or the location are showing now. Kangiwa Car Wash, Sheikh Jafar Mosque, Ram, Kastana Ram Office. You can see that name of location are showing. So that's the advantage of Google Hybrid, using Google Hybrid as your base map. So another thing I want to show you here is here, this place. If you click on these three dots, it will give you, if you have projects before and you click on projects, it will bring the list of the projects you have. So if you want to create more projects, you click on this plus sign to create projects. Me, I'm just in, for this session, I'm just introducing you to the interface, what this software contains. Then if you bring create a project, I want to start to be recording features. This icon here is record. This rec is to rec for recording feature. If you click on it, you see record feature, record tracks. So if you, this one is what you use to record features. So then there is issue, this app is very good in data collection, but the you need a template. That template is a project dependent. Depending on the project you are executing, that what determines the template you use, because each project may have their own templates. So for you to be able, for example, when I click on this layer, if you have templates, that template will display here. But for now, this is just introduction. By the time next series parts, we will start a project and I will use a particular template to demonstrate it. So if you have a template, it will display here. So if you want to add layer, let's say you have a shape file and you want to add it, this is the icon you use to bring in a layer to the interface of this software. So another thing is that you can zoom in and you can zoom out using your finger. If you want to zoom in, you can use your finger to just two fingers to zoom in or zoom out. So then, as in B, we have a project. If you come back to this big icon, and if you have a project, you can use this zoom to extend, to zoom to the extent of your project. And of course, your project attributes, you can view it here. And it also have a search button here. Then if you move down here, you can see import project. If you have a project you are doing before or have done in another device, you can copy it to this new device and you can import it into the this software interface. And of course, we have the import template. You can also bring in a template. Then the next thing is that this software has a share icon, where after you have done your project, for instance, this share icon, if you click on it, you can share your projects as a SW map project format. You can share it as KMZ or KML. You can share it as a shapefile. You can share it as JSON, as a spreadsheet, it as a CSV, or as a spreadsheet, as a geo package. So this software is small but very, 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 very interesting, because it's very good for GIS data collections. So this is just introduction to this software interface. In the next video tutorial, I will show you how to start data importation of data or shapefile to this interface, and of course how to use it to for data collection. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.